Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create a powerful sci-fi graphic of backlit text floating in deep space. Create a new document by pressing Ctrl-N on Windows or Command-N on a Mac. Name it whatever you'd like. Make its width 1550 pixels, its height 870 pixels, and the resolution 150 pixels per inch. The color mode is RGB and 8 bits per channel. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. If your foreground and background colors aren't white and black respectively, press D on your keyboard and then X to invert them. We'll fill the document with black, and since black is the background color, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete. Open your horizontal type tool and open your list of fonts. Choose a font you like. I'm using Aldo the Apache Regular. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link in my video's description or project files. I'll make its size 183 points, sharp, and center alignment. Click on your document and type out your text. To increase or decrease the space between characters, highlight them and press and hold Alt or Option plus the right or left arrows on your keyboard. To center your text on your document, open your Move tool and press Ctrl or Command A to select it all and click the Align Horizontal Centers icon. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command D. To slide your text down or up, press the down or up arrows on your keyboard. Ctrl click or Command click on the large T to make a selection of your text's shape. Ctrl click or Command click on the new layer icon to make a new layer below the active layer. Go to Select, Modify, and Border. Make the width 25 pixels and click OK. We'll fill it with white, and since white is the foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Then deselect it. Double-click the large T to highlight the text and click the color box to open the color picker. Pick black and click OK. Open your Move tool and go to Layer, Rasterize, and Type. We're rasterizing the text so we can apply certain effects and filters to it. Make Layer 1 active and change its blend mode to Dissolve. We want to keep the Dissolve effect, but make the layer's blend mode normal. To do this, click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Shift-click on Layer 1 to make it active as well. Then, merge the two layers by pressing Ctrl or Command E. Now, we still have the Dissolve effect, but its blend mode is normal. Name it Radial Blur. Go to Filter, Blur, and Radial Blur. Make the amount 100%, the blur method zoom, and the quality good. Drag the crosshair to a location that approximates the location of the top center of your text. Then click OK. Your first few tries may not be accurate, so just press Ctrl or Command Z to undo the last step and try again until you're happy with the blur's location. Increase the blur effect by pressing Ctrl or Command F a few times. Notice the subtle striations in the blur. This is because the layer that we applied the radial blur to was originally stippled by the Dissolve blend mode. To slightly lower or raise the location of the blur, press your down or up arrow on your keyboard. Next, we'll brighten and colorize our image. Make your top layer active and click the adjustment layer icon. Click Hue Saturation. Check Colorize and drag the hue slider to a color you like. I'll increase the saturation to 100%. We'll make a copy of the text. First, make the layer active, and then press Ctrl or Command J. Drag the copy below the original text and name it Shadow. Go to Edit, Transform, and Flip Vertical. Press and hold Shift as you drag the shadow down until it's flush with the bottom of the top text. Go to Edit, Transform, and Perspective. Go to a bottom corner and drag it out until the shadow's perspective angle matches the perspective angle of the radial blur. Then press Enter or Return. Press the down arrow on your keyboard to lower the shadow until its top edges are aligned to the bottom of the top text. Next, we'll make the shadow gradually blur and fade out. Make a copy of the shadow and click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask next to the copy. Press and hold Alt or Option as you drag a copy of the layer mask next to the original shadow. Make the shadow copy layer active and go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Make the radius 1 pixel and click OK. Make the original shadow active. Go back to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. This time, blur it 8 pixels. Then, click OK or press Enter or Return. Click the layer mask to make it active. Open your gradient tool and gradient picker. Click the black to transparent gradient and the linear gradient icon. Go to the bottom of your shadow and press and hold Shift as you drag up the gradient line to approximately here, then release. To sharpen the top part of the shadow, make the top layer mask active. Place your cursor approximately 3/4 of the way up the shadow and press and hold Shift as you drag up the gradient line to the top of the shadow. Next, we'll add a glow around the rim of the text. Make your text layer active and click the FX icon. Click Outer Glow. If your version of Photoshop is earlier than CC 2015, your layer style window will look a bit different. Make the blend mode Color Dodge, the opacity 35%, and the size 10 pixels. Then click OK. Next, we'll add a small bright flare at the source of the radial blur. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Name it Source Light. Open your Elliptical Marquee tool and go to the center of the source of the radial blur. Press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag out a circle approximately this size. Go to Select, Modify, and Feather. Feather it 50 pixels and click OK or press Enter or Return. Open your gradient tool and click the radial gradient icon. Go to the center of the circle and press and hold Shift as you drag the gradient line across approximately twice the distance of the diameter of the circle. Then release. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command D. To slide the flare up or down, press the up or down arrows on your keyboard. Next, we'll add a lens flare. Make a composite snapshot of your image by first making the top layer active and then pressing Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Go to Filter, Render, and Lens Flare. The brightness is 100% and the lens type is 50 to 300 mm zoom. Drag the lens flare over the center of the glow and click OK. Because the preview window is so small, you may have to reposition it a few times to get it over the center. Lastly, we'll add stars to the background. Since the text is blocking the radial blur from shining through it, we'll block the stars from shining through it as well. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Fill the empty layer with black, and since black is the background color, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete. Go to Filter, Noise, and Add Noise. Make the amount 100%, Gaussian, and monochromatic. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Make the radius 0.3 pixels and click OK or press Enter or Return. Press Ctrl or Command L to open your levels window. Drag the input black slider to approximately 170 and click OK. Change the blend mode to Color Dodge. Ctrl-click or Command-click on the text to make a selection of it. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the stars layer. Right now, the stars are showing through the text, but not the background, so to reverse the effect, we'll invert the layer mask. To do this, press Ctrl or Command-I. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.